much. Thank you, music lovers. We're happy to be back here at the Suwannee Park here. This is fertile bluegrass territory here. We have a new CD out, the first one in 7 years, called Dog Nation. We'd like each and every one of you to become a citizen of Dog Nation. You can do that simply by buying this CD and or the accompanying t-shirt. But we'll give you some samples of what it's like to be a citizen of Dog Nation. We walk around hearing this music all the time. This is called Mellow Maine. Thank you. so much. This being bluegrass country, legitimate bluegrass country here. We'll play something in the order of dog grass. It's great to see a guy like Ralph Stanley get some real recognition after a lifetime of sticking with his roots. I know Ralph played in these parts for many years. Still does, I'm sure. And of course, Vassar Clements. One of the great bluegrass musicians produced in Florida, along with the great Chubby Wise, and the great Chubby Anthony. We'll play a little Telluride for you. so much. Maybe we'll go back to a CD called Dog 90. Get a little mellow here and play the piece called Gypsy Nights. That's a good life. Thank you. band now for 26 years, and I realize some of you are possibly younger than that, or some of you are possibly older than that. In any case, I'm the only original member left. That worked out okay since they named the band after me, but I'd like to introduce these guys to you. They've been with me longer than any other group, both individually and collectively, and they are doing a wonderful job with Dog Nation. On bass, a man who's been in this band for 17 years, playing the upright acoustic string bass from Pacifica, California, please welcome Mr. Jim Kerwin. Next fellow over here plays just about anything he gets his hands on. Or feet, or anything he comes close to turns into a Stradivarius. He plays mandolin, fiddle, percussion, sometimes near concussion. We worry about him sometimes. But a man of a myriad of musical abilities. He's been in the band for 13 years. He's got a CD out called Camp Town that no acoustic environment should be without. And he hails from Dixon, California. Please make welcome Mr. Joe Craven. Next fellow over there plays the flute and the bass flute, occasional percussion. He's been in the band for 13 years as well. The 13-year-old boys. It's their dog bar, dog mitzvah. In any case, he's got several CDs of his own out. One project that he produced himself called the Headwaters Project. Almost the Swamp Waters, but the Headwaters. All the proceeds go to raise money for the California redwood trees. Speaking of California, anybody got the score? It's another world here. I'm talking World Series. In any case, getting back to introducing this very talented member of the band, from San Anselmo, he also has a CD called Flute Jazz. And I helped him make that. It's on the Acoustic Disc label. So try to pick up one or both of these projects if you like what he does, and even if you don't. It's hard to imagine. Anyhow, he comes from San Anselmo, California, Mr. Matt Eckel on flute. Finally, the latest member of the group. He's been in the band for over 9 years now. And he's the man with the Latin touch. He comes from Cordoba, Argentina. And in fact, that's the title of one of his CDs on acoustic disc. Another is Solos from South America. And a brand new project that he did with his beautiful wife, Yolanda Aranda, called Intimo. One man, one woman, one voice, one guitar. Intimo. No bedroom should be without any of his CDs, really. The man we call El Magnifico, Enrique Coria, on guitar. And How many of you have seen the Grateful Dog film? Well, I'm proud of my daughter Jillian for putting that together. And tomorrow is her birthday, so we're going to play Grateful Dog. Thank you, Jerry. another one off our new CD. This is called Bluegrass at the Beach. It has a lot more to do with the beach, I think. I should mention a new CD out on acoustic disc called Old and in the Gray, featuring Peter Rowan, Vassar Clements, myself, Herb Peterson, and Bryn Bright. Brand new CD, just came out. We'll go back to the earliest days of dog music, back when the giant mandolins roamed the earth. I'll send this out to Tony Rice, Mike Marshall, and Daryl Anger, my some of the pioneers of dog music, who helped me get this thing started, and we're going to have a little reunion tomorrow. Hope you all can check it out. Opus 38. Shady Grove, my little love. Shady Grove, I say. Shady Grove, my little love. I'm going home. So area, we always like to check out the local talent. And we found some local Florida boys here. And we'd like to invite out here. They know several of my numbers. I don't know what order to introduce these guys, but, well, the first one comes from this state, and he was a member of my band for quite a few years, and he's one of the world's great mandolin pickers. Please welcome the great Gator Mike Marshall. And a Floridian. And we got some friends that I met through Gator, a man named Jeff Pinkham and his son Josh. They're going to come up and help us too. So Jeff and Josh. And I think we've got another fiddle player around here, Mr. Darrell Anger, if he'd show up. Record this. Well, we hope you enjoy this. This is a little thing called, it's a peppy tune. Soria on guitar. Jeff Pinkham on mandolin. Jim Kerwin, bass. Josh Pinkham on the mandolin. Mike Marshall on the mandolin. Daryl Anger on the violin. Joe Craven on the fiddle. Matt Eckel on the flute.
And of course, the man we call Dog, David Grisman.